Welcome to the Marvelous Designer in CFX series. For part one, we will be looking at the tint used in the first shot. In this series, we will be using 3ds Max and later Unreal Engine for outputting a cinematic. The principles used here are also transferable to Maya, Blender, etc. To start with, a cage for the tint was built. The canvas will be attached underneath the poles. For the avatar in Marvelous Designer, the ground will need to be included for the canvas to rest on. The tint is built in four similar pieces and then sewn together where they are going to be attached. In the front of the tint, a heavier canvas will be needed that the character can push open when it emerges from the tint. This will all be set up with the fabric settings. The canvas will be attached to the main center pole using these small straps attached to these rings. I was able to make one strap and then copy and paste the rest and sew them to the internal lines that line up to the rings. To get the wrinkles on the straps attaching the canvas to the poles, the straps were made longer than the internal lines where they are sewn. Before I move on, it is useful to set the UVs even though I will be editing them later in 3ds Max. Using the UV packing option will automatically lay out UVs for you. It is fine that all UVs are on one UDIM for this workflow. Once the tint canvas is built, I export it as an OBJ with the following settings: thin, unweld, and single object. The tint movement was simmed with a planar wind with 10,000 strength and 80 turbulence. As you can see, the tint fabric for the door is a heavier cloth and does not move as much. I have set the weight to 90, friction to 18, so it stays in place, and thickness to 20. For the movement of the tint canvas in the wind, we will be using a point cache. 3ds Max uses the point cache too. For Maya, you can use the Maya cache options. Make sure the export settings are the same as the settings used to export the OBJ. I always use unweld and thin, as any thickness needed I will add later. Lastly, for this cable on the tint, I used an animated turntable to wind up the inner wires. Pin the top of the three fabric pieces that will make up the inner wire. Next, pin the bottoms of the pieces to the turntable. Record the simulation. Because I want this to be wound more, delete the garment animation at the end and scrub to the beginning of the sequence. Unattach the pins and reattach to the turntable. While it would have been easier to just use a twist modifier in 3ds Max, I like the more organic and random way this looks. The ropes that are holding the hanging bags were made in the same way. These ropes can be exported as thick. To position the cable, we will make a long, thin pattern that will drive the finished cable. Pin the top and bottom of the pattern. Set the fabric to be leather. Position the cable where it should be attached using the pins, and while the simulation is running. Because the Marvelous Designer ground plane is higher than the geo from the scene, I need to turn it off. Export an OBJ and name it Cable Simmed. Right-click in the 3D window and select Reset 3D Arrangement. Export another OBJ and name it Cable Flat. In 3ds Max, import both cable pieces and use the morph modifier so the cable can move from flat to the sim shape. Add a shell modifier and make it around the thickness of the cylinder. Build a cylinder to fit around the flat cable. The coiled wire will fit inside the cylinder. Using skin wrap, wrap the cylinder to the cable piece. With Animate on, morph the cable from flat to the simmed shape. Export the cylinder, which now deforms from flat state to simmed shape, as an alembic. Back in Marvelous Designer, import the cylinder as an avatar. I will use the same cloth used for the cable animation and widen it so I can wrap it around the cylinder avatar. A quick way to do this is to select pin and double-click on each long edge of the pattern. This will select the entire edge at once, and then move the pin selection so it goes around the cylinder. Select the top of the pattern with pins and attach to the avatar. Record the simulation. Now we will fix the outer cable hose. I am using the shrinkage weft and shrinkage warp on the pattern to create a loose-fitting hose. Export as an OBJ. This concludes part 1 of this series.